Please subscribe to our channel and for latest update, click on the bell icon.
Hello everybody. Now I'm going to talk to you about the power of tolerance. Do we have tolerance? Yes, we tolerate so many things that happen in our lives. Right, but what is the level of tolerance? That's a different question. It depends on the situation. For example, if you're traveling in a very crowded bus and if somebody is accidentally bumping into you or, you know, hurting you, it's okay to tolerate, right? But if they are doing it on intentionally, then you cannot tolerate. You're not supposed to tolerate. You have to raise your voice. So that this is where we make a difference as an individual, the power of being tolerant. Let us look at a few strategies. Before that, I would like to tell you what tolerance is all about. Tolerance is willingness to accept others and their beliefs, even if you don't agree with them. You have to tolerate somebody else's views and opinions, even if you do not like it, even if you do not agree on it. So if we have this tolerance, we would be able to work easily in groups. We'll be able to work easily in teams. If we do not have tolerance, I'm sure we will not be successful, because nowadays our working patterns, our working styles, our nature of work is all networked. It's all networked. It's not one man show. Everything is a series of action. So you need to be tolerant. For example, you may have a particular style of coding. You may have a particular style of dealing with a particular client, but one of your teammates chooses a different method. There you have to show tolerance, because if that person is getting the same result or the desired result, you have no reason to get angry with them. You need to tolerate, you need to accept certain things as long as the desired output is obtained. Let us look at a few strategies. Listen carefully without jumping to conclusions. When you are in a meeting or when you are in a process of discussion or when you are in a position to take a decision, we should not jump to conclusion. We should be ready to listen to other people's views. And sometimes it's very embarrassing when you are stopped. You're not allowed to express yourself. You feel very insulted. You feel frustrated, right? So you never want to give that kind of feeling to somebody else. Always encourage people. Let them speak. Listen to it. Before you conclude, listen to them. The next is, try to understand the other person's view. I have underlined this word, understand, because I'm not asking you to accept, but I'm asking you to understand. It may not work, you know, in your mind that the point or the message or the technique which your colleague is sharing may not work, but try to understand it. Once you understand, then you can explain to your colleague as to why it will not happen. But well, in the beginning itself, if you are going to tell her or him, no, stop, I know this is not going to happen, I know where you're getting to, you're going to curb that person from saying something, you're not going to have a good relationship with him or her in future. You need to be tolerant. Listen, understand, and then deliver your message. The next is, agree to disagree. Sometimes we are all this yes master. We never disagree because of fear. We fear the future. We fear the consequences if we disagree. Therefore, if you feel 100% that this particular output or this particular solution or result or action which the group is taking is not going to work out, you simply have to agree in yourself to disagree. And just don't be very nasty in just disagreeing and walking out or shunning you away from the project. Instead, give them the reasons as to why you are disagreeing. So, sometimes we tend to say, I'm not obligated to tell you or tell her why I disagree. Nobody is obligated to anybody. Just because you have a boss who earns a little bit of more money than you, you're not obligated. You are paid for what you do, she's paid for what she does, right? So there's no obligation. It's just that commitment of the company that helps the company succeed. When the company succeeds, only the company can pay you, right? So let us have that attitude of being tolerant. Accept whatever happens, but have the ability to politely disagree, to make them understand why you disagree. So at the end of the day, this involves a lot of thinking. It involves a lot of networking. I would like to share with you a story about a monk, a junior monk and a senior monk. The junior monk was in charge of a piece of land where he had to cultivate. But he was very playful, not focused, and not willing to work. So the senior monk was actually observing his behavior, but did not call and, you know, correct him or give him any suggestion or give him any advice, nothing. So the senior monk was just observing the power of tolerance, right? Because even in our college life, even in our employment, we will have seniors and juniors, right? You may be a senior or a junior, whatever is your position, you need to have the power of tolerance. Now, through this story, we will just listen and understand how the senior monk had the power of tolerance, and therefore he was able to change the junior monk and get the desired result. So let's see. The story goes on where the junior monk is up to all the tricks and never worried about the piece of land which was given for cultivation. So the senior monk is just observing and being tolerant. And one day when he was, one night actually, when he was, you know, walking around or rather inspecting the various rooms, to, because various juniors were given different assignments, he realized that the junior monk, the naughty junior monk, had actually placed a stool and got onto the stool and jumped over the wall and gone elsewhere to have some fun, to enjoy, to see the outer world. And so the senior monk, when he's seen this, it, had it been you or me, we would have waited there, waited for the person to come back, and we would have given A to Z lecture, taken necessary action, termination, etc., etc., whatnot, everything we would have done. But what the senior monk really did was, he removed the stool from that place because he knew the junior monk needs to come onto the wall, jump onto the stool, and then come to the room. So the senior monk just removed the stool. And when it was time for this junior monk to come back to the room, because he went slyly, he went without telling anybody. So the senior monk was watching. He seen the shadow coming towards the wall. He knew that it was the junior monk who's coming towards the wall to jump on the wall. So immediately the senior monk placed his hands on his knees and bent like this. So what happened was, since it was dark and it was, you know, nighttime, the junior monk stood on the wall and he just landed on the back of the senior monk. So on placing his foot, you know, on the junior monk's back, he realized that this is not the stool. But the junior monk just jumped off and then he looked, it was the senior monk. So how scary is that? You have actually placed your feet on the back of your senior. And that's number one. Number two, you have not, he has broke the rules. He has, you know, left the monastery and he has gone out for the night and enjoyed himself and he's come back. So this is, you know, a very blunder, a very big mistake in the life of a monk. So, but the senior monk, as soon as he seen the junior monk, as soon as he seen the senior monk, he was so terrified, he was so much frightened, he just ran quickly to his room and went to sleep. And the next morning, when he seen the senior monk, his heart was going pitter-patter as to worrying, what would the senior monk do? Would he tell everybody? Would he terminate me? Would he disgrace me? Would he, you know, degrade me? All these things were happening in the mind of the junior monk because he made such a big mistake. But the senior monk did not reveal this incident to anybody. He just continued and kept doing whatever was required for the regular activities. So the junior monk himself realized that the senior monk has been tolerant and has been kind enough to forgive me. So let me stop playing all these tricks and let me be more committed towards the job that is given to me. So automatically the junior monk changed his approach towards the cultivation of the land. So and at the end of the year, the cultivation was very good. So the junior monk was appreciated. When the junior monk was appreciated, he ran back to the senior monk and thanked him for being so very patient and tolerant. Now this is just an example. You may be a team leader, you may be a person in charge of your assignment or a project or something. By having the leadership position, we do not become superior. We are just equal. So understand that it's important to understand your team members. Just as how the senior monk understood the naughtiness of the junior monk, but gave him the space to realize and grow. So that is the power of tolerance. And I would like to share my own experience where I did not have the best of bosses in my life. I had one particular boss who was not very good to me because of my own positive skills, which was actually, you know, dominating the others in the organization. So this was not going very well. And whenever it was my personal, for personal reasons, when I had to take leave or when I had to do some kind of special assignment, I was not treated the right way. But I was very patient and I did not, I was actually on the verge of resigning. I was, every day I would go to work with a heavy heart because I didn't like my boss. I didn't like the way she treated me. I didn't like the way I was treated indifferently. I didn't like the way I was denied certain things. Every day I would wish I was never going to work again in this place. I wish, that was a kind of mantra which I was actually saying in my mind. But I was very humble. I made no complaints to anybody. I was very tolerant. And finally, on the 1st of April in 2015, I had an internal promotion. So that actually changed my complete career. I got a better boss. I got to learn many other aspects. I'm grown so well today. And, you know, this is just an example which I'm sharing with you. Likewise, you may be having different challenges in your life. Just be tolerant. You do whatever is required. Follow a few strategies to keep yourself mentally and physically fit. And automatically, through the power of tolerance, you would be able to taste victory. Remember, take my life as an example, as I just shared with you. You may be having the devastating experience at office. You may be having the worst colleagues. But trust me, you be tolerant and do whatever is required for your growth, and automatically you will see success. Good luck to you.